Welcome to the video tutorial lessons on econometrics. In this lesson, we are going to learn about the stochastic error term. In a typical econometric model such as y equals beta 1 plus beta 2 x plus u, the u parameter is known as the unobserved factors, primarily due to the fact that there are other factors that collectively affect y but are omitted from the model. This is also known as the error or disturbance term. And there are many reasons why the error term is included in an econometric model. First is vagueness of theory. The theory determining the behavior of y often might be incomplete. For instance, we might know of the consumption theory where income affects consumption, but we might be ignorant or unsure about the other variables that can also affect consumption. Thus, the parameter u is used as a substitute for all the omitted variables from the model. The second point is unavailability of data. We may not have enough quantitative information about some variables we want to observe in an econometric model. Data might just not be available on a particular variable, so that variable is simply omitted and the u parameter substituted. The third point is core variables versus peripheral variables. For instance, in the consumption income model, besides income, other factors such as size of household, gender, religion, education, and others might affect consumption. However, perhaps information on education generally is not available, so we are forced to omit the education variable from the model despite its theoretical relevance in explaining consumption expenditure, so the u parameter simply replaces it. The fourth point is intrinsic randomness in human behavior. Well, even if all relevant variables are included in the model, that human's susceptibility to committing errors in modeling cannot be explained no matter how hard we try. Thus, the combined effect of this randomness in human behavior is treated as a u parameter. The fifth point is poor proxy variables. Oftentimes, there might not be enough information on a particular variable to be measured in a model. For instance, there is not specific data on poverty, so we might want to use income as a proxy where a threshold is defined, and all who lie below this threshold are considered poor, and we use that as our variable for our estimation. If it happens that income used as a proxy for poverty is actually a poor proxy variable, then there will be serious implications for estimation, and hence the u parameter is used as a substitute for that. The sixth point is principle of parsimony. This principle requires that only relevant and important variables must be included in econometric modeling. For instance, in estimating the behavior of quantity demanded, we might, as far as we can, include price, price of related goods, and income. The other factors such as taste and preference, age, population, weather, might not just be relevant to the model. Therefore, they are excluded and the u parameter introduced as their substitute. The seventh point is wrong functional form. In an econometric model, there are times we may not be able to specify a model that captures effectively the relationship between variables. The variables may be linear, non-linear, or may even require some logarithmic functional transformations to measure the relationships. In a two-variable regression, perhaps the functional form can be judged from a scatter diagram, but in a multiple regression model, it may just not be easy to visualize. So we introduce the u parameter to account for any error that we might commit in determining relationships among variables. In the next lesson, we will consider the two-variable regression analysis and learn about concepts such as linearity, expectation, or conditional expectation, sample regression function, population regression function, and others. To this end, I hope you found this lesson useful. Thank you and have a nice day.